Give me a smile. Okay, no smile. Don't ever smile again.
So, how did you make your money?
I exercise control in all things, Miss Steele.
And you don't want somebody like me. You're such a stallion!
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, we got the one and only Sam Atkins. That's right, he's here live in the station. We want to welcome him to Smooth 90.5 FM. That's right, that is one of his, that's just a little snippet of what his song is we're going to be playing today on Smooth 90.5 FM. You got to give us a call at 708-345-0563. That's 708-345-0563. Smooth 90.5 FM. That's right. We are so excited to have this wonderful jazz artist. Now, let me tell you how I came about to meeting Mr. Sam Atkins. I happened to be at an event and come across a young lady. She said, I know this jazz artist, he's really good, you gotta have him on your station. I'm like, oh, okay, well, you know, is he local, is he professional? No, he's professional, yeah. I'm like, okay, well, I'll check out his CD, we'll put it up. And she said, well, he's gonna be performing tonight. I said, really? Where is he gonna be performing at? He's gonna be performing at this banquet facility, and they do jazz events there. So we went there to just to check it out and see what's going on. So we went there and it was jamming. And I mean, this man had it going on. And we were so excited that he gave us the opportunity to come into the station. And we are looking forward to having an amazing show with Mr. Sam Atkins. Hankins is his name. H-A-N-K-I-N-S. Hankins. This man, what type, Mr. Hankins, tell me what type of saxophone, and welcome to Smooth 90.5 FM. How are you doing today?
I'm doing wonderful, Rob. Thank you for having me here. And, man, it's great to finally meet you and sit across from you and chat with you.
Oh, man, it's wonderful. It's amazing to have you as well on Smooth 90.5 FM. We are... Well, tell me, how did you get into playing, and what is it about jazz that got you into it?
Well, I would have to say it's something I was born into. You know, growing up with my father, you know, as a musician, my brother's musician, you know, hanging around my uncles, aunts, singing in church, you know, so this is something that came very natural. And the trumpet was just an instrument that's pretty much called me.
Okay.
And I just basically started, you know, listening and just listening as much as I can, you know, records. And basically it was Louis Armstrong that really got me started.
Louis!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we just did a tribute to Louis today. Oh. Yeah, the life of Louis. And we also did a story of Nina Simone. Mm-hmm. Right. Which is not really her real name. A lot of people don't know that.
That's true. Yeah, she definitely changed the name.
Yeah.
But yeah, Louis was he was the one. I was just sitting an old video, and I think it was in a class, and they were showing a video of Louis Armstrong, and I was just like, that's what I wanted to play. So I went home to my mother. I said, I want to join a band. I want to play the trumpet. And she just said, okay, sure. You know, she just thought it was going to be a phase.
Okay.
But she said, you know, your uncle used to play the trumpet. I think it's at your grandmother's under the bed somewhere. So, you know, couldn't wait to get down to my grandmother's and get it. Found the trumpet. It was old, you know, had to work on it for a while, but I just started trying to play it. And it was love first sight.
Well, you got it working, and you got it. And how many trumpets have you gone through the years of being a jazz musician?
Ooh, oh, I think at this point where I'm finally settled down to one, I probably went to about 7 or 8 different types of trumpets.
7 or 8 different types of trumpets. Now, is there something unique about that instrument that you feel that is losing its craft in today's society? I mean, back in high school, you know, mm-hmm. you had the young kids playing the trumpet, mm-hmm. you know, for band and bugle and everything, ROTC and things like that. Right. What is it that you feel that young kids really need to pick up from the trumpet and learn about it?
Well, first of all, you know, any instrument is, you know, it's going to require discipline. It's going to mm-hmm. require time, you know, learning the craft, learning the technique. Trumpet is oh, well, in my opinion, it's a beast. You know, it has his. I think every instrument has its problem, but trumpet, you know, we have to manipulate a lot of things. Our armature, we have to manipulate the pitch. You know, all this is coming from our lips. You know, for those who don't understand what armature, basically, you know, like air, and like I said, we only have 3 vowels, so we got to make a lot of, you know, pitches between those 3 vowels, and
okay,
and it's endurance, you know, it's just like anything. But you know, if anybody want to do it, they just got to realize it's going to take time.
You got those fingers I guess they call you, someone told me the best trumpet players are the best crack safers. Because the hands move so fast, and they can move them tumblers over.
Well, I don't know about that. I haven't tried that yet. I don't think I'd be very good at it.
Okay. Yeah. Well, tell us about that event that I seen you at. Tell me about it.
Oh yeah, that night was the CD release party, this was my 4th CD that is out now, called Do That Thing, and you know, I wanted to, you know, share it, and I wanted to have at least a CD release, and so, you know, that was the perfect event, perfect place to do it, and like I say, it turned out really well. I was surprised. You know, a lot of people was into it.
Ladies and gentlemen, you got to tune in here, because we've been playing his music for the last couple of days. We have so many people listening on here. I have this list I have right here, Sam, as you can see. You see those numbers up there?
Wow.
I wanted to show you these numbers.
Wow.
You can see right here. This is from playing your CD. And this is from New York, Boston, Houston, Green Bay, Charlotte, Jackson, Mississippi, Philadelphia, Seattle, Atlanta. This is where my listeners are listening at, and they are tuned in like crazy, and they are jamming every single minute of the day.
Thank you, man.
Is this your second CD that you have out, or your first CD? Which one is this?
Oh, well, like say, my first CD was called Dreamcatcher, and my second CD was Nothing Between Us, and my third CD, I did a Christmas CD with a friend of mine.
You did a Christmas CD?
Yeah.
We're going to have to get that in our Christmas repertoire.
Sure, yeah.
Okay, Nothing Between Us.
Yeah, Nothing Between Us is my second CD, and then I did a Christmas CD with a good friend of mine, David McLaurin. And this one here is my 4th CD.
Oh, 4th CD.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we're going to have to, you know, find out. Now, there's different instruments. I'm just learning. Like, I did not know there was a difference between an alto saxophone and a mm-hmm. soprano. Is that the same with a trumpet?
Well, yeah, you do have various sizes of trumpets. You know, you have a very small miniature of a trumpet. It's called a cornet. It's a little bit smaller. And you have another instrument that's a little smaller than that. It's called piccolo trumpet. You find that in your classical or baroque playing. Then you have your different trumpets with different keys. You have a C trumpet, you have an E flat trumpet. And also you have a bigger trumpet. That's something I play on a lot, or I roll out most of my songs on this particular instrument. It's called a flugelhorn.
Okay.
It's mostly, for those who are back in the day, to remember Chuck Mangione, who made the song Feel So Good, kind of brought that out. And a lot of people, a lot of jazz artists, you know, use that flugelhorn a lot.
Okay.
You know, so that's just the one instrument that, you know, I enjoy playing.
What is it about this industry of jazz? A lot of radio stations are trying to switch over to certain different types of format, but mm-hmm. jazz is the root of all music, with gospel and blues is all on the same realm. Mm. When you have a young student, high school, or young kids see you out performing, what is it that you tell them about this music? What about this industry?
Well, basically, you know, it just depends on those two folds of how I approach it. You know, if I'm having students come out just to come out and listen and you know, enjoy the music, you know, I may explain to them, you know, hey, you know, this is about entertaining, you know, just about the gig, about what you need to do within the audience, you know. But on the other hand, you know, if they really want to get into this industry, this lifestyle, that, you know, they need to be aware that it's not going to happen overnight. It's going to be you're going to hear a lot of no's and yes. You're going to have some thick skin because you're going to have criticism. People are going to say something or they just don't like what you're doing. And you just you can't give up. You can't stop. You know, even though you feel like you want to give up, you got to have at least a mentor that you can go to and talk to. And
now, the group that you were performing with, was that your band or a band that...
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
That was my band and, the guys who were willing to work with me. But I'm blessed to have them. They're phenomenal musicians, and I couldn't ask for more.
Okay. So tell us about your group. Who's in it? What do they play? What instruments do they play?
Sure. I'll start off with... I'll start off with drums, try to work my way up. His name is David Yokley, a phenomenal drummer, and he's been with me for a little bit, and he's been with me about a couple gigs and everything, and great player. On bass, we have Mr. Will Howard, phenomenal bass player, who's, you know, he has his own groups as well, plays everywhere, and a guitar, we have Alan Barrow. Alan is very smooth guitar player.
And, okay.
Very great personality. On keys, we have Seth Black, and a phenomenal player as well. His ears are really, really big. I'm not saying just he has big ears. I'm just saying he can really hear a lot. Really can put things down and what you're looking for. Then on sax, I consider this gentleman my big brother, Mr. Ollie Reed.
Okay.
And everybody knows Ollie. He's been a fixture here in Chicago, played just about everywhere with everybody. We do a lot of playing together, and you know, he has his own group, and so sometimes I'm back there playing with him, and vice versa. If I got my group, he's back there playing with me.
Okay, all right. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go to a short commercial break, but in the meantime, we're going to want you to give us a call at 708-345-0563. That's 708-345-0563. Smooth 90.5 FM.
Some of y'all may not be used to this. Step into Jesus, no. But I want y'all to know something this evening. It's okay if you do it from your heart. So come on, if you feel like I do, this is what I want y'all to do. Y'all ready? Here we go.
If the music sounds good and you feel alright, take a step to the left, one to the right. Shout loud and make a joyful sound. Don't worry about anybody else around. Then take your hands, raise them to the sky. Open up your heart, let them in your life. Confess with your mouth, let it die. And if you believe that, you'll be alright. If the music sounds good and you feel alright, take a step to the left, one to the right. Shout loud and make a joyful sound. Don't worry about anybody else around. Then take your hands, raise them to the sky. Open up your heart, let it in your life. Confess with your mouth, let it die. And if you believe that, you'll be alright.
Alright, y'all. Now that we've done step for Jesus, it's time we take it to church. Here we go. Listen. It's alright.
All right.
Call
Smoover 90.5 FM. I want to thank everybody for tuning in, and hopefully you guys are enjoying this show because we have a wonderful artist here. Oh man, Mr. Sam Hankins, this music is nothing between us. We even have your flyer on our website as well, the music as well. So if you want information, he has a great CD out called Do That Thing. Actually, it's four CDs, but the one we're playing right now in the station, it's called Soft Touch and You Should Have. That's what we're doing, and also Do That Thing. So we have three of his songs in rotation. So we wanted to give you a feel where most radio stations will just keep dragging one little particular song for a whole entire month. We give you a sample of everything that he is playing. You know, you can listen to us at late night on Friday's Jazz Sessions here on Smoover 90.5 FM. And where are you going to be performing at next?
Well, I hope to be performing probably back out TNJJ's probably sometime in July. But I do have some things in work right now, just trying to solidify and confirm. So I may be at some festivals somewhere around, you know, around the city. But hopefully in a couple of weeks, I should know what I'm going to be doing, you okay. know, the previous okay. months. But I will definitely let you know and you know, give you that information.
Well, if somebody wanted to get in contact with you or try to get a sure. copy of your CD, how would they get your CD? Is it on iTunes? Where is it at?
Yeah, the typical outlets. You know, if you want to do the digital download, you can go on CD Baby, iTunes, or Amazon. Now, if you're looking for the hard copy, now what I do, I sell them the hard copies off my website. You can go to my website if you want to order a physical CD with my autograph, you know, if you like. You can go to www.samhankinsmusic.com. It's very easy, just samhankinsmusic.com, and just go on my website and just go on the tab shop and you should be able to order.
Maybe we can get you come in here on a night that you're not busy and do a jazz night. We have a show called Jazz Nights, mm-hmm. where we go back in the history of jazz and talk about the essence of jazz and the yeah. spirit of jazz. Yeah. And man, maybe we can get you to come in and be one of our premier sure. Jazz artists. Yeah. You know, a lot of people want to know about jazz, and mm-hmm. but they don't understand about jazz.
Right, right.
And it's a craft that it takes time to work with. What is it that inspires you to stay in the game so long?
Well, that's a good question. I never thought about that. It's something I enjoy. I don't, you know, I guess what I do, I don't consider it as a job. I don't consider it something mundane. You know, this is something that makes me who I am, makes me me. It's something I enjoy expressing myself, regardless if it's the straight hair jazz, bebop jazz, or smooth jazz, as they say, or contemporary, whatever type of form. It just allowed me to express myself. I think that I can't speak for all artists out here, but, you know, this is something they enjoy doing, you know, expressing myself and playing for others.
Now, you were just talking about bebop jazz and acid jazz. What type of jazz do you classify your music to be in?
I would say more smooth contemporary. You know, it has more of the contemporary sounds that you hear in your typical, you know,
contemporary jazz.
Yeah, contemporary mm-hmm. jazz, you know, in your music. And, you know, that's just something, you know, that kind of came to me. You know, very easily. You
okay.
know, some stuff I heard and melodies and it's like most of my music be considered smooth or contemporary jazz.
Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you want more of Sam Hankins, you can go to our website at WGSJBCRadio. WGSJBCRadio.com. That's WGSJBCRadio.com. Or you can tune in and listen to our weekly broadcasts on Wednesday night and Friday night for our jazz jam session on Smooth 90.5 FM. Give us a call at 708-343-3906 or 708-345-0563 or 64. We have three lines. Don't forget, we have our Google Android app where you can tune in and listen in. And also, if you want to be interactive, you can also, we have an app on there where you can interactively click on there and the artist's picture, and it will automatically play their song for you. And if you want to purchase it, it'll take you directly to their link or to their site. Smooth 90.5 FM, Smooth Jazz Radio. This is Rob G. broadcasting live on the station that plays the hits, and we are so happy that we have Mr. Hankins. Do you have anything else you want to wrap up and let everybody know about where you're going to do next for your next project? What's the inspiration for your next project?
Well, at this time, I'm working, doing a collaboration, you know, like one of the musicians that I work with on with my Christmas CD, his name is Mr. David McLaurin. He's out of Dallas, Texas. And so, you know, we're kind of doing something with that, but that'll probably be down the road another year and a half before that, you know, actually come out. But right now, I am just enjoying just Do That Thing CD and just hopefully to get it out for others to hear and also be able to help get my band out and perform for others.
You heard it live on Smooth 90.5 FM HD Radio. Sam Hankins, y'all. Give us a call, and we're going to be playing his music all day tomorrow. It's in our rotation. So we see the numbers. We see people that really enjoy the sounds of Sam Hankins and other artists that we have performing. Don't forget, June 11th, we're going to be out at Miller Meadows Forest Preserve right across the street from Loyola Hospital for the 5K run. We'll probably we'll be playing some of his music out there as well. So if you want, we'll see if we can get him to come on out there and do a little celebrity high by, and maybe we can get him out there to do a 5K run too.
I don't know about that.
run with his trumpet, you know. Yeah. Okay. But we are so excited and happy. Are you a resident of Chicago?
Yes, I am.
Born and raised here?
No, I was born and raised in Oklahoma City.
Oklahoma City. Oh, is that on our sheet? Oklahoma City. I think I've seen Oklahoma City on there. But are you a resident of Maywood?
No, I'm a resident of Olympia Fields.
Olympia Fields. Come all the way out here to jam in our session. Yeah. On Smooth 90.5 FM. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, we have Mr. Sam Hankins. Y'all got to give us a call on Smooth 90.5 FM.